Good morning and welcome to our next Junior Church video. Again, if you don't know me, my name is Natalie and I'm part of the kids team at Legacy Church in Walsall. Now I'm going to start off this week by asking you a question. When you meet somebody new, let's say you have a new child arrive at school, or there's somebody new in the area, somebody you've never met before, when you meet them for the first time, what do you remember about them afterwards? You see, I must admit, I do tend to look at people's shoes. It's not because I'm not interested in the rest of them or what they've got to say, just because I've got a love of shoes. So what do you look at? What do you look at? And what do you remember about that person afterwards? You see, sometimes we can get it spot on. We are correct about that person. We might look at them and think, they look like a really, really nice person, or they look like somebody who's troubled, or, you know, they look like they might be a good friend. But, you know, sometimes we can get that wrong as well, because it's not always about how somebody looks on the outside. And today we're going to be looking at how God sees us, not how we see us or how we see other people, but how he sees us. So we're going to be looking at a book in the Bible called 1 Samuel. This is in the Old Testament. Now, to give you a bit of background, Samuel was like God's representative to the people. And the people of Israel at that time, they wanted a king. Okay, so Samuel was appointed by God to go and anoint someone, to go and find the next king or the king for Israel. So God told him to go off to Bethlehem and meet with a man named Jesse, because it was one of Jesse's sons who was going to be king. So Samuel went on his way and he went and found Jesse. And Jesse brought out his oldest son. His oldest son was called Eliab. Now, Samuel seemed to think that it would be the oldest son. And you can understand why you would think that, couldn't you? This was the next king of Israel. This was to be a man who would rule a nation. So you wouldn't expect it to be the younger brothers. You would expect it to be the eldest. And so Samuel straight away said, bring out your oldest son. But you see, he brought out Eliab and God said, no, let him pass by. He's not the one. And then Jesse brought out his other sons, and he brought out 7 sons in total in front of Jesse. And each time God said, no, it's not that one. And Samuel said, have you got any more sons? And Jesse said, well, there's still my youngest son, but he's in the field and he's tending the sheep, but he's just a young boy. And Samuel said, bring him anyway. And so Jesse's youngest son came and stood before Samuel. And the Lord spoke to Samuel and he said, this is he. This is the one who is going to be king over Israel. Anoint him with oil. And so David, young David, was anointed with oil. Now, let's think about David, because you probably know who he is. This is David, who was the shepherd boy. Then there was David, who defeated Goliath. David was also a brilliant musician, and he used to write songs, and it was him who wrote psalms and songs to the Lord. And then there's David, who was the king. So, you see, it's not always about outward appearance, is it? And actually, that's what our verse says this week. So let's have a look at that. It's from 1 Samuel chapter 16, verse 7. And it says, the Lord said to Samuel, do not consider his appearance or his height, for I have rejected him. Now, this is when he was talking about the first brother. The Lord does not look at the things man looks at. Man looks at the outward appearance, but the Lord looks at the heart. So to Samuel and to Jesse, and probably to all of David's brothers, David didn't seem like the right person for the job. He was the youngest. What did he know about ruling people? What did he know about having any responsibilities? He simply looked after the sheep in the field. He didn't know how to look after people or how to look after his family even. And so, you see, it's easy for us, isn't it, to look at the outside of somebody and think, oh, I don't think that they could do that. And actually, we get it completely wrong. God doesn't look at our outward appearance. He looks at our hearts. Now, we need to look at other people's hearts in the way that God looks at them as well. We need to do that. We need to see other people as God sees them. So let's pray and ask God that we would be able to see other people through his eyes. Let's do that now. Lord Jesus, we ask you, Lord, to give us your eyes when we see others. Help us to see all the good things about another person, Lord. Help us to see their heart and what they're really about. Not what clothes they wear or how they've styled their hair. Lord, all these things might be very appealing, Lord, when we look at somebody. But we need to look beyond all of that and look at their hearts. Help us to do it in Jesus' name. Amen. Now this week, for our craft activity, to help us to remember that, we are going to make some heart-shaped spectacles or glasses. So if you keep on watching, I'm going to have a go at making some of those and you'll be able to have a go too. Remember our scripture this week. It's from 1 Samuel chapter 16 verse 7 and it's all about how God looks at our hearts, and that's what we can do as well when we view others. So have a go at our little craft, and that will be coming up very shortly, and I will see you all next week. Stay safe. Bye.
Okay, so I've got my piece of paper, I've got a pen for drawing, got a pair of scissors. Okay, so first of all, I'm going to put in the part that goes across my nose. And then I'm going to draw my heart. You are mighty God, perfect in all your ways, you were here before my first breath, and you'll be here when nothing else is left. You are mighty God, forever and always. Say you're too big, hey, forever. You're too wise for mistakes. Yes, you are mighty, perfect in all your ways. Hey, you were here before my face. So now I'm going to cut out the middle, and I'm going to do this by folding that over. And I'm going to cut a shape like half a heart inside, so that when I... Can you see that? Yes, I've got heart-shaped glasses there. And I'll do the same on the other one. I should look something like this.
Ta-da! Watch this. Heart-shaped glasses. Now, of course, if you're going to make some and you don't wear glasses like me, then you need to make some arms. That's this part at the sides. So all you need to do is extend that part on your paper and fold it over. But if you do wear glasses like me, you can just make some that stick over the top of your own. And I think I might keep these on today. I like them very much. Have fun making yours, and I'd love to see them. See you next time. Bye.